Hi students, today we are going to discuss about vernier scale. See, it is a measuring device used to measure lengths with a more precision. What is meant by precision? What is meant by more precision? For instance, the value 2.1 is more precise than value 2. 2.15 will be more precise than 2.1. 2.158 will be more precise than 2.15 and so on. So we can say for a given measurement, greater the number of decimal figures, greater the precision of the value. Okay. So vernier calipers is used to measure lengths with a more precision. Think about a meter scale. Which is of 1 meter length, has been divided into 100 equal portion, and each division is called 1 centimeter, 1/100 of a meter, 1 centimeter. And if you observe that, you will see that each 1 centimeter is further divided into 10 equal portions. Okay, and each of this portion will be 0.1 centimeter or 1 millimeter, 0.1 centimeter or 1 millimeter. And using a meter scale, the smallest length that you can measure is a millimeter, okay, or a multiple of millimeter, and that is called the least count of a meter scale. Okay. See, we cannot have a still more precise value using a meter scale because it is practically not possible to divide 1 millimeter into another 10 subdivision, because the very 1 millimeter is so narrow. So if at all you divide, it will be very difficult to observe and get the value. So practically that limitation is there. And vernier calipers, it is the device designed by a French mathematician in the year 1632 to get more precision value even without subdivisions at a particular level. How that can be achieved, that we will understand. See, look at the vernier calipers. It has two scales. One is the main scale, okay, and the other is the vernier scale. Vernier scale is said to be an auxiliary scale or a sliding or movable scale. It can be slided over the main scale. Okay. So there are two scales in the unit. Okay. Before using a vernier scale, one has to standardize it or one has to calibrate it. How to calibrate a vernier scale? For that, you slide the vernier scale until its jaw exactly meets the jaw of the main scale, so that zero spacing between the two jaws. If you do so, it is expected that zero of the main scale exactly coincides with the zero of the vernier scale. That happens when this distance is exactly same as this distance. So, if construction is perfect, those two distances will be same, and when we close the caliper like this, zeros of two will exactly coincide. Then we can say that there is no zero error in the device. Zero error is nil. The construction is perfect. We have calibrated the device. But another thing is that this may not happen always. Sometimes the zero of the vernier scale may stand more shifted towards left or more shifted towards right in comparison with the zero of the main scale. If the zero of the vernier scale is more towards the left of the observer, it is called negative zero error. And if the zero of the vernier scale is towards the right of the main scale, zero, it is called a positive zero error. We will discuss that later. For the time being, we consider a vernier calipers with a zero, no zero error. Zero, zero error. no zero error. Okay. Okay. Now, suppose you want to measure the length of a metal strip. The thing you have to do is to place the metal strip so that it is held tight in between the two jaws. Okay. Now, regarding the vernier scale, we have to understand some points. See, the vernier scale has been divided into 10 equal, in most scale it is divided into 10 equal portions. A definite length is divided into 10 equal portions, and this 10 equal portions must exactly coincide with the either 9 or 8 or 11 or 12 divisions of main scale. 10 divisions of the vernier scale and either 9, 10, 11, 12, etc. divisions of the main scale must be exactly coinciding in length. Please remember, the 10 divisions of vernier scale should never coincide exactly with the 10 divisions of the main scale. If that happens, this the device is useless. Either it must be less or it must be more. Okay. In our explanation, I have chosen a vernier scale where 10 vernier scale divisions are exactly equivalent to 9 main scale divisions. 10 vernier scale divisions are exactly equivalent to 9 main scale divisions. Okay, in that case, look here. Main scale division. See, it's a designing is in such a way that each main scale division is 1 millimeter or 0.1 centimeter. So, main scale division MSD is 0.1 centimeter. Okay, and in this particular scale, 10 vernier scale division is equal to 9 main scale division. I told you, 10 vernier scale divisions exactly coincides with the 9 main scale division. In that case, we can calculate the length of one vernier scale division. Then, one vernier scale division is equal to 9 by 10 main scale division. But we know main scale division is 0.1 centimeter. So, 0.9 into 0.1, 0.09 centimeter is the vernier scale division's length. Now, we want to get the difference in the main scale division value and the vernier scale division value. That will remain a constant for a given vernier caliper. And that constant is called vernier constant or least count. Most popularly it is known as least count. So, vernier constant or least count LC is equal to main scale division value minus vernier scale division value. We know both 0.1 minus 0.09 is equal to 0.01 centimeter. Okay. Now, we are going to find the length of a strip, metal strip, which has been placed in between the two jaws. See, for that, first you observe the main scale division. Look here, look at the zero. Zero of the vernier scale comes in between 0.3 and 0.4 of the main scale division. One thing you have to remember, you don't have to worry about this distance in the beginning because this is exactly compensated by this. So, it is as if the scale starts from here. Practically, it is as if the scale starts from here. Okay. So, see, the length of this device, main scale reading is 0.3 and in between 0.3 and 0.4. But that is not the exact coincidence. See, the actual length comes up to this, isn't it? Because 0 is coinciding nowhere. There is no mark there. And vernier theorem helps you to determine this distance, this x, that distance. And so even without a line there, we can determine the length x. How that is possible? That's the logic of vernier theorem. Look here. See, when we place this metal strip in between the two jaws, And if you observe all the vernier reading, you will see that one of the vernier reading exactly coincides with one of the main scale reading. If you, in this example, I have chosen fifth vernier scale division to coincide with one of the main scale reading. See, the 5 coincides with the 0.8 centimeter. 5 coincides, that 0.8 centimeter, that value has no relevance at all. 5 has relevance, but 0.8, we just want one of the vernier scale division must exactly, one of the main vernier scale reading must exactly coincide with the one of the main scale reading. Okay, now think. See, when we proceed from here to here, when one, here this exact coincidence, but see in the next line, fourth vernier line, it is not exactly coinciding. Why? Because we know that there is slight difference between the vernier scale division value and main scale division value. We also know that main scale division is slightly more by 0.01 centimeter. So we can say this difference, small difference I have shown in blue color, is one least count or 0.01 centimeter. Now you consider two vernier division and here two main scale division. See, in that case, the distance between the main scale reading and the vernier scale reading will be doubled. Double of the least count. So 2LC, 2 into least count will be this blue length. For the third line, it will be 3 into least count. The difference between the main scale reading and the vernier scale reading will be 3 times the least count. Here it will be the 4 times the least count. And finally, here X will be 5 times the least count. So what we have achieved by applying vernier theorem, we got the length at a particular distance even when there is no line of demarcation there. So this is the logic, this is the idea of vernier. Okay, so now we can say what is the total length of this metal strip. It will be this plus X, main scale division, which is 0.3, and what X, but we have found that X is nothing but least count into coinciding vernier division. Coinciding vernier division is the fifth vernier division, isn't it? 5 into 0.01. So the total reading is 0.35 centimeter. So now we know what is the actual length, even when there is no subdivision for the millimeter reading, we got one more subdivision number. So we got a more precision result. Think, in the absence of such an approach, we will have to restrict our value to be first decimal figure only, either 0.2 or 0.3. We are not sure of any value in between these two. So there will be only one decimal position in the measurement. By applying the Vernier's theorem, we got one more decimal figure. This is the advantage of using a vernier calipers. Hope you understood up to that. We'll continue. Now we proceed to know the zero errors in case where zero of the main scale and the zero of the vernier scale does not coincide. Let's see that. Okay, now we will consider about the application of zero error other than zero. Zero error other than zero. There are two situations. In the first case, see, the zero of the vernier scale division is towards the right of the main scale zero. Then the error is called positive zero error. How to determine that? See, how much the difference? See, the error is the distance between two zeros. So it is X in the diagram, this distance. Okay. Zero error is equal to X. How to get that? See, the main scale reading for this measurement is 0 itself. Main scale division is 0. Plus, you want to get this blue distance, which itself is x, this distance. How we get that? By applying the same vernier principle. For that, you check for a line of coincidence. In this particular diagram, I have chosen fourth vernier division to coincide with the main scale, one of the main scale division. Okay, here, this coincided with this. And when it comes to the next line, we know there will be no coincidence, a slight difference of one least count will be between the two lines. Because vernier scale division and main scale division differ by one least count. When we consider second, the total difference between the two lines will be twice the least count. Here it will be thrice the least count, here it will be the four times the least count. So we can also say that x is nothing but 4 into least count. Okay, so again we apply x is equal to MSD main scale division plus least count into coinciding vernier division. 0 plus 0.01 into 4 is equal to 0.0104 centimeter. So, 0 error here is 0.04 centimeter. And after calibrating this device, we used to measure the length of some body using the same meter scale. Then you get a particular value. From that value, or from that value, this 0 error has to be subtracted. What I mean, if 0 error is 0.04 centimeter, 0 correction is 0.04 centimeter, because that much less will be the actual length. Okay, because we got such a value just because 0 stands more towards the right. Okay, so we have to compensate that by subtracting the same value. So 0 correction is 0.04. Now imagine the next case where 0 of the vernier scale stand to the left of the main scale 0, as seen there. Okay, look there, 0 is standing to the vernier scale 0 is to the left of the main scale 0. Here what is the error, what is the correction? Again, the value between two zeros, here it is shown as x. We apply the same equation. 0 error is equal to minus x. We get it by the same equation, MSD plus least count into coinciding vernier division. But here one doubt arises. Which may see the 0 line of vernier is standing in between minus 0.190. So should we take main scale division as minus 0.1 or 0? The rule is that you to take the lower of the main scale division value. So here it is minus 0.1. Here also we have done the same. Look here. When the reading comes between 0 and 1, we took 0 as the main scale division. If it comes in between 0.1 and 0.2, you take 0.1 as the main scale division. Again, if the 0 comes in between minus 0.1 and the next minus 0.2, we have to take minus 0.2 as the main scale division. Then only the sign complication will be avoided. So we get minus 0.1 plus 5 times. Here the coincidence lies, I have chosen to be the fifth line. So fifth line exactly coincide. Fourth line will make a difference of one least count. Next will make a difference of two least count, three least count, four least count, five least count. So here the difference is 5 least count between the two, so between minus 0.190. So minus x is equal to main scale division plus least count into coinciding vernier division minus 0.1 plus 5 into 0.1. So minus 0.05. Here one thing you have to remember, here while we do this operation, we are not getting x. See, 5 LC and X here is not the same. Here they are same. So if you do proceed this way, you directly get X instead of 5 LC, that this difference value. So be careful about the sign convention. Then only we get the exact required result. For instance, if it were 4LC, this distance would have been what? 0.04. Then this distance would have been what? Minus 0.1 plus 0.04, 0.06. We know this is 0.06. Since this is 0.04, this is must be 0.06. So by adopting this technique, you always get the required result. So here we come to the conclusion that zero error is minus 0.04. See, in that case, to the main scale, we have to add 0.05, not minus 0.05. Because since the vernier scale is standing towards the left of the main scale zero, the directly measured length will be less than the actual length. So we have to compensate by adding a positive value. Okay, in that case, zero correction will be plus 0.05. See, regarding the application of zero correction, by looking at these two, we can make a conclusion. We can make a generalization. What is the generalization I have written here? Look, in both cases, negative of the zero error is added to the main result to get the actual length. I repeat, in both cases, negative of zero error is added to the main result to get the actual length. When the zero error is 0.04, we have to add minus 0.04. When the zero error is minus 0.05, we have to add 0.05. So this statement holds good for both the cases. Hope you understood that also. We will continue with the see, now we have to think of that vernier scale where the length of vernier division is more than the main scale division. That also, even though it is less discussed, that also has to be considered. Main scale division is slightly less than vernier scale division, so that MSD minus VSD, which is least count, becomes negative. We will proceed to look into that in the next video. Okay, bye, take care.